Yo, what's up YouTube? This is Smeekwook here, and in today's video, we're going to be finding out what would happen in the NBA if every team lost their best player. So, looking at these rosters here, as you can see, each team is missing their best player. 76ers, no Joel Embiid. Bucks, no Giannis. Bulls, I actually didn't take anybody off because their team is so bad. I mean, Zach LaVine's the best player. I'm not going to screw them over and not even have a player over 80. So teams like that, I didn't take out their best players. Cavs, of course, losing LeBron. Celtics, no more Kyrie. Clippers, they don't have Blake anymore. Grizzlies, Marcus Gasol. Hawks, I didn't take out anybody either just because if they only have one person over 80, I didn't want to screw them over. Miami Heat, Hassan Whiteside's out. Hornets, Kemba Walker, Utah Jazz, they had Rudy Gobert. I did take him out just because he was like an 88 overall, but if somebody's just an 80 and everybody else is under an 80, I'm not going to take them out. Kings also have the same roster just because they only have one person over an 80. And then Knicks, Porzingis isn't in anymore, Lakers, Brooke Lopez, Magic, did we even take anybody out for the Magic? I don't know. Mavericks, Harrison Barnes is out. Nets, I don't think we took anybody out here. Nuggets, we took, was that Gallinari? I believe so. Pacers, did we even take anybody out? I don't even know. I don't even know half these teams. Pelicans, of course, no Anthony Davis anymore. Pistons, no more Andre Drummond. Raptors, no more DeRozan. Rockets, no more Harden. Spurs, no more Kawhi. Suns, no more Booker. Thunder, no more Westbrook. Timberwolves, we have no more Cat. Karl Anthony Towns. Trailblazers, no more Lillard. Warriors, we have no more Durant, but they still have two people over 90. I wonder if, I should probably take out Curry, too. Just to make that more even, we'll leave him in. Maybe in a second season, if they're too dominant, the Warriors, then we might take him out. But the Cavs also have a sick team as well. And then Wizards, no John Wall. And we're going to hop right into this. Leave your comment down below which team you think is going to win. I think the Warriors actually still might take this. Obviously, I have no say. I'm not going to do anything to affect the wins. We're just going to simulate through this. And guys, go check out my new channel in the description below. I'm also going to leave my friend's channel down there as well, so go check out his channel, try to give him some subs, just tell him I sent you. Why not, just send it all over there, guys. And yeah, I'm going to be doing reactions and vlogs on my new channel, so definitely go check that out. We're at 500 subscribers. Thanks for getting me to that. I literally haven't even uploaded a video yet, and it took me so long to hit 500 subs on this channel. It took me like 2 years just to get, longer than that, to get to 500 subs, and we're there in like a week, and I haven't even uploaded that. So thank you for that. Anyways, we're going to simulate the season. I'll see you guys in the playoffs. We're going to turn off injuries. We do not want anybody getting injured. That's no fun at all. I mean, if there's no injuries in real life, that would be awesome. But unfortunately, that can't happen. Let's simulate through the season. I'll see you guys in the playoffs and find out who did the best in the league, which teams were the best, who's the best players are, and stuff like that. Anyways, guys. Okay, so here we go. We're into the playoffs right now. Stephen Curry with the MVP. 33.7 points, 7.1 assists, just straight killing it. Lonzo Ball gets Rookie of the Year. Jeremy Lin, sixth man. DeAndre Jordan with the Defensive Player of the Year. CJ McCollum gets the Most Improved. And Steve Kerr gets Coach of the Year. So I believe the Warriors did get the best record. But on the All-NBA first team, we got Stephen Curry, Chris Paul, Paul George, Draymond Green, and DeMarcus Cousins. So a lot different than what we would normally see on the second team. I mean, look at these players. Normally, these guys would not. Eric Bledsoe, no. Jabari Parker, he's definitely not making any NBA teams in real life. Lonzo Ball made the third team. Bradley Beal, Carmelo Anthony actually made. Okay, he's up to an 86 overall. Good stuff by Carmelo, Paul Millsap, DeAndre Jordan on the All-NBA 13. You guys can check out this defensive team. And we got the rookie team. So Lonzo making all-NBA, all-defensive, and all-rookie. That is insane. Jumping into the playoffs here, though. Let's check out the stats first. League leader Steph Curry leading the league, 33.7 points. CJ McCollum with 31. We have two players averaging over 30 points. CJ McCollum going huge when Lillard's not there. Paul George also doing insane. Bradley Beal, DeMarcus Cousins. Kyle Lowry actually put up some numbers, almost a double-double. We have Chris Paul putting up an insane double-double, 23 points, 12.4 assists per game. Really nice by him. Klay doing really good as well. Isaiah. Zach LaVine actually is kind of up on top, number 10 there. So that's pretty cool for him. Anyways, let's check out these standings. Going to the conference standings, of course, Warriors up on top. Then we got Rockets, who have Chris Paul. Thunder with Paul George, Clippers. And down at the bottom, the Trailblazers are one of the worst teams, I'll say, with the Spurs and the Timberwolves. Kind of surprising some of those teams are down there. The Kings almost making playoffs. And then going over to the West, Cavs still the top team. Wizards still up there. 76ers, Raptors, Bucks, Bulls, Hornets, Celtics. Kind of how it turns out in real life normally. Not too much of a difference there. And of course, some of the teams that no longer have their best player are. Anyways, we're going to hop into these simulations of the playoffs. Let's just go round by round here. See who moves on. We'll probably do another season after this just to see if Golden State dominates. We might also just turn off, take out Stephen Curry if Golden State gets too good. So we might do that next season. We'll find out though. Moving on here, Jazz are out. Okay. All right. Warriors moved on. So the top two teams in each conference are going to move on. It's going to be Golden State and Houston versus Cleveland and the Wizards. Cleveland beating out the Raptors. I wanted my Raptors to go a bit farther, but it did not happen. Rockets, so it's going to be Warriors moving on, and the Cavs. It's going to be the same NBA Finals, despite losing their best players. And who's going to take this? Oh, I did that. I only did one game. Okay, let's do it game by game. 2-0 for Warriors, 3-0, and it's a 4-0 sweep in the Finals. Stephen Curry with Finals MVP. I think we're going to take him out next season, just because he's kind of too OP, and the Warriors are still an insane team. So we're going to take out Steph Curry in an upcoming season and see how it turns out again. So we're still going to have the same teams though, advance the season, have the rookies and all that, just with no Steph Curry next season. So I'll see you guys at the beginning of next year's playoffs, I believe. So yeah, I'll see you guys there. Okay, so we simulated another season, this time without Stephen Curry in it. DeMarcus Cousins gets the MVP this game, averaging a double-double in points and rebounds. Rookie of the year goes to Michael Porter Jr. Tyreke Evans actually gets sixth man of the year on the Cleveland Cavaliers. Draymond Green gets defensive player of the year. And Tyus Jones gets most improved. Dwayne Casey with the coach of the year. There we go. My Raptors up on top here. Isaiah Thomas is on the Thunder. Now, I guess there's some trades last season. Isaiah Thomas is on the Thunder. Kyle Lowry is on the Raptors. Paul George came to the Raptors. I don't even know what ended up happening. Draymond Green on the Warriors. DeMarcus Cousins on the Jazz. I thought I turned off trades, but I guess not. Marvin Bagley up there. Who else do we have on these All-NBA teams? Anybody else on different teams? I think that should be about it. All right, we're just going to hop into these playoffs. Let's check out these standings. Who did the best or the statistics? League leaders, Isaiah Thomas leading the league, and he is on the Thunder. So the Thunder replaced Paul George with Isaiah Thomas. 34.8 points per game. Paul George is on the Raptors, who made a huge improvement somehow. Paul George getting 28.0 points per game. And then Klay Thompson doing pretty good as well. But the Warriors didn't even make the playoffs, as you are about to see right here. Over in the West, the Jazz coming up on top. And the Warriors are one of the worst teams in the league. Over in the East, it's going to be the Raptors taking it. Celtics, Hornets, 76ers, Cavs. Let's just jump into these playoffs. It's going to be a bit different because there's some trades that went down and everything. But Steph Curry is no longer playing for the Warriors, so they're probably not going to end up winning. And let's see who all moves on here. It's going to be Raptors, 76ers versus Charlotte, Indiana. Utah moves on. Houston, Lakers, and the Nuggets. Let's keep on simulating. See who's going to make it in these playoffs. Raptors actually get eliminated. The Nuggets and the Rockets move on. So I thought Raptors were going to be the top team, but apparently not. Let's check out this box score. Who's on the Hornets? Is this Norman Powell? Are you kidding me? He's the best player for them? Okay, this is so bad now. There's like no good players in these playoffs right now. We got the Rockets versus the 76ers. Who's on the 76ers anyways? Who is honestly on them? I don't even know. I don't even know. All right, 76ers. We got Markel Fultz. Okay, he's killing it. Ben Simmons is killing it. So this is actually a dope team despite losing Joel Embiid. And of course, the Rockets have Chris Paul. It is 1-0. Can we go? Okay, here we go. We're on the 76ers now. It's 2-1. 3-1 for the 76ers. 3-2. And the 76ers have won the championship. Markel Fultz gets finals MVP. There you go, guys. Somehow, some way that happened. The first season was pretty realistic how it ended up turning out. Everything kind of got messed up in the second season. Anyways, guys, that's kind of what would happen if every team lost their best player. It was kind of the same. Like, the Warriors still have the most dominant team because they added one of the best players in the league to their team after being one of the best teams already, which is crazy. Cavs are still going to be up there. They still have an insane lineup. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this video. If you did enjoy it, smash that like button. Go check out my new channel, my friend's channel. Turn on post notifications. Subscribe if you're new. This has been your boy, Smeekle, and I will see you next time. Peace. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 M's in my bank account.